Last month, hundreds of researchers from all over the world started the largest ever Arctic expedition aboard a ship just over 500 kilometers from the North Pole. What makes this project even more unique is that the entire ship will be frozen, embedded in sea ice for an entire year. So it begs the question, why are they even doing this? For starters, it's the most ambitious climate change expedition ever attempted of the Arctic. The Multidisciplinary Drifting Observatory for the Study of Arctic Climate, or MOSAiC, will be studying the effects of a warming climate on the central Arctic's atmosphere, ice, ocean, and ecosystems. By drifting with the ice for a year, the team will be able to collect the necessary information to create better climate models to help inform what the Arctic will look like as it continues to warm.
For us, there are a number of knowns and unknowns. The knowns are that we are going out in the Arctic with all kinds of instrumentation, more than has ever been on a ship before out in the Arctic. We know we're going to get a lot of first measurements of many types of data. So a first look into things like wintertime aerosol properties, first look at scanning cloud radar measurements. Then there's a lot of unknowns, and those are really related to the conditions that we're going to encounter there. So the sea ice, we're really at the mercy of the sea ice.
When they arrived at their destination, the German icebreaker called Polar Stern chose the perfect ice floe to attach itself to. A crucial part of this mission since the ice needs to withstand the weight of heavy instruments. This ice floe will serve as the so-called ice camp for the expedition's experiments and a landing strip for research planes. Once frozen in place, the scientists will have to set up camp quickly as winter is coming for roughly 150 days. And come November, they'll be operating in complete darkness. And that is when nature takes over. Drifting at about 7 kilometers per day, the frozen ship hopes to follow the path taken by ice floes along a phenomenon called the transpolar drift. This path will allow the ship to drift from the pole and move south towards the Fram Strait, located east of Greenland, where the expedition will come to a close. The ship will have about 100 people aboard at a time. It will be frozen in place in complete darkness while research continues. And the Polar Stern will be at the center of most of MOSAiC's research, containing laboratories and technical equipment on board to take measurements and observe the environment. At the base camp, experiments will be divided into different hubs, like Rove City, which will use remotely operated vehicles to observe marine organisms and collect water samples from beneath the ice. Or Met City, which will measure the composition of the atmosphere using tethered balloons, which will continuously float 2 kilometers above the camp. On top of all the research, the Polar Stern will have a distributed network of observational sites operating within a 50-kilometer radius of the ship, which will be equipped with remote and autonomous sensors to collect additional oceanic, ice, and atmospheric data.
At the end of our year in the Arctic, we're going to learn a lot about the new Arctic system with thinner sea ice, with the interactions that are adapting themselves to the change. We're going to learn a lot about how the Arctic is manifesting.
And in the spirit of collaboration, the researchers will upload their information to a database, making it accessible to their hundreds of MOSAiC colleagues worldwide. So we'll just have to wait and see the anticipated results of this expedition that could help us better map the future of our planet. Are there any other scientific expeditions that you'd like to see us cover? Let us know down in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe to Seeker, and thanks for watching.